time to be like fiber optics. Individually, we make beautiful light, but together we become as a laser light. So if you want to shine bright, do you really like it? Ask yourself. Welcome. Dove of love, may he lead the way so that we can know. The blessing of the voice of Diana Ross. It's time to take off, to sail away, to go with this blissful breezes at our backs. And if we will not be afraid to leave the shore, the treasure of excellence and the priceless pearl of great reward is in the deep. So it's time to go forward, forward in a world that would sooner lose a spouse and never look back. It's time that we rekindle old flames. My wife and I, we've recently kissed and made up, and I hope that lasts. But if it doesn't, it's better to have loved and lost than to have never have loved at all. So it's time that we all start singing the same song to get ourselves on the same page where we can finally get along with one another. And as we reverse our curse, it's time to ask, do you know where your best hopes are taking you to? For it's time to follow our hearts to create peace, to have confidence in the miracles that we were fearlessly and wondrously created to be, so that we need to believe in ourselves because life is right now. Time to discover our deepest passion so that we can enjoy the little things and dream the big dreams, the unity that love alone can bring. So ask, do you like the things that love is showing you? And do you want to know where your relationship is going to? Or do you already know, to your chagrin? Do you know, sadly, that your fast fading embers of your marriage needs desperately to blaze again by love's unconditional passion with your lover? So together, with your recommitted adoration, that you can once again let your love begin flowing like a bottomless river of our most passionate and deepest desires, the union thereof flowing in peace with harmony and melody made from two quivering souls. And so we need to be like the lutes and the flutes, all playing beautiful music together. So ask yourself, did you know that all of it is possible to blaze again, brighter than we've ever blazed before? And so it's time that we need to understand that if we let our love wax cold between us and our wives or husbands of yesteryear, then that's letting many dreams just slip away through our hands. So ask if it's possible to reconcile. Ask your left behind wife or husband why the two of you should risk being ignorant to your beloved partners if you won't turn back to one another. While waiting far too long before finally seeking love's fullness within their marriage, if they will but choose to love another again, to move and with forgiveness, so that they can stop ignoring all the needs of one another. Otherwise, they'll sadly come to see that the answers to all such questions can end up being pretty bad. So it's time that we need to realize what life is showing us. So let all embracing lovers of love also see that if you haven't had good marital love, then it's time to rekindle that flame. So let it go again and again. To reverse our curse, love alone shall accomplish that. And so in this time, we need to look behind us, and we don't want to suddenly see that there are no more open doors, for the dove of love is calling us to ascend higher, the most regal eagle of the eons, that we can mount up on eagle's wings, and so that we can see that what we were once hoping for is what the dove of love wants us to have. For even though love is patient and kind, sometimes we must awake to the bitter truth that toxic selfish kinds of love is like slowly losing your mind. It causes poison to get into your spirit. So it's time to get on the same page. And so ask yourself, did you know that double-minded, uncommitted lovers are now standing still in time while chasing their useless past fantasies that always filled their minds with wasted thoughts? So it's time to reject all that has been vanity of vanities, saith the preacher, as we sail away. The wind is full and the tide of love is with us. So ask yourself one more time, do you really know where you're going to? For as John Lennon said, it's always been true that the love we make is the love that we take, for we only get back what we put out. So if you really wanna like the things that life is showing you about love, then realize that love is not even love unless it is given away. And if you're already doing just that with your significant other, then their doors to their deepest heart of hearts will never close unto each other, so that both can have love evermore until death do they part, just like they were always hoping for evermore. And so it's time to embrace our brightest wish of love's unconditionality, for such loving love is all in all, and it is the end of all religion as it has been known on planet Earth, if we will let the dove of love take control. So do you want your once dead love to thrive and to be alive once more? Because love always wins. There is no way that it cannot. And are you willing to make a covenant of love, an unbreakable promise between you and your significant other, to your wife or to your husband, to love them unconditionally to the very best of their ability and the levels of their forgiveness, which is love alone turned inside out? So ask yourself if you will dare to understand that truth. And if you will, it's time to get with that program. Have a moment of silence for all marriages that have no redemption. But the Lord earnestly desires for reconciliation to happen. For the truest truth is that all things need to be restored. And so in this hour, let the music play on, because it is an utter orchestra of delight if we will follow that blessed wind until we move long out of sight from our past troubles and our past loveless relationships, as we put down a new gauntlet, a gauntlet of love, as we move beyond yesteryear's trap. For if we don't get out of our comfort zone and forgive, even if it is not deserved, then we can never become the people that we need to be. So do you want to know? Do you want to know the truest truth? because if you do, it's time to move along. And so ask yourself, if you're willing not to forgive one another, ask yourself if you like the appeal of loneliness, that a life without your unforgiven partner, that life is offering you. And did you know that none of us struggling within our marriages ever really knows where any of us are going to if we won't forgive our lovers again and again, even until it hurts and hurts some more? Because sometimes, either for things that have happened or for any imaginations thereof, there is no recourse but to let go and let God, and to let go of our love so that our love covers all error. And so did you know that all those wishing to shine beautifully as our most radiant star of stars in the splendor of His Majesty, our Majesties, that they can help us to behold love's purest truth, that love divine has always been unconditional, for it is neither aroused nor diminished by the other's value or qualities, since it is a spontaneous gift, unconditional love that always seeks nothing but best wishes given back unto the giver who first sent it. And did you also realize, well, that the greatest power that mankind could ever possibly achieve has always been the unlimited power of our unconditional love set at liberty? So it is time to beat our sword into the sickle for His harvest of love, as Revelation 14 says. And this we must do upon the Lord's Latter-day Mountain. And we must beat the sword into the sickle, just as Isaiah 2 and Micah 4 says, for if we will not, we could never have a kingdom age arising. And know that all this will work really, really great, understanding these things, for all those willing to kiss and to make up, if they'll always keep loving their marriages without any limitations to their forgiveness, and no more boundaries, as much as humanly possible. So it's time to step forward and reverse our curse. But as we do, we must raise our hands unto heaven and not be so hard upon ourselves. For we can't sail away and love anybody else unless we love ourselves first. So it's time to go forward and do just that. The Lord wants to remove all shame and all guilt from every one of us. So He says unto all people of love, He says the words of Jeremiah 31. The Lord says, I shall be your God, you shall be my people. I shall forgive all your iniquity, all your wretchedness, forgive all blasphemies other than the unforgivable sin of letting your love light go out. So be as little children, let your love be fanned again. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, and your marriage shall be healed, says the Lord God. And so it's time to reverse the curse again and again. Curse it at its roots. And so let all lovers of love, willing to put a smile upon their face as they turn to their others, and let them embrace their wives or their husbands, and let them make a great new resolution to make new bonds of love by putting forth new levels of rededication. It's time to rededicate to one another in the marvelous wedded bliss of love's forgiveness, and to bring forth the glorious restoration which can flow like His heavenly sapphire sea of His love's eternal forgiveness does. But let the wise among all reconciling spouses additionally understand that the hardest thing in the world for any of us is it's hard for us to accept pure, unconditional, true love and acceptance. For we have been brainwashed and conditioned to falsely believe that there's got to be some strings, that there's got to be something that we're missing. It's not normal to have a love like that. So let's not be normal anymore. This world is awfully abnormal. So it's time to lean not unto our own understandings. Let our love flow again as a river, and to have new acceptance for your lovers, knowing that it doesn't have to be earned in any way, their love, because it is as freely as it is given, so let it also be received. So did you know that since we all receive God's unconditional love, it's up to all of us to love unconditionally too, to be a reflection of the great light which He first sent us. And this means being able to receive as well as giving. And it's time over and over. Let the music flow. Because as the music and harmony of the melody of our love flows, it'll do battle for us at the gates of hell and reverse the curse. So in these days of Noah, that the Lord's love might be set free. For it is written, the most important word in the Bible is Jeremiah 30:24. For it is written, and it shall be considered in the latter days. The Lord is saying, I shall return my fierce, terrifying anger if my beloved will just give me the desire of my heart to be loving and forgiving people, to mirror the everlasting Father who first sent forth His light unto all of us. So let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. And let all healing within broken marriages, let all mending also come to see that no amount of money, no amount of success, ambition, no amount of compatibility, eagerness, or horniness, or good intention, none of that. None of that can ever give meaning to sustain our relationships like unconditional love can at its purest. Because it is the purest gospel truth for all lovers of love, that when we know that even one person really does love us unconditionally, then we are finally set free to fly higher that indeed than we've ever gone before, because then we finally begin feeling connections to everyone else around, if only we will love ourselves by the forgiveness that is the ocean of our Lord's fast-moving rapids of His living waters. For these are the days of the great refreshing. Otherwise, if it does not come, then the Lord is kept in reserve in heaven and cannot return exactly as it is foretold in Acts 3:21. So ask yourselves one more time if you really know where your best hopes are taking you without love being active as a child in your life. So let it loose and go with a new flow, and let it flow to your spouse. And so ask yourself again and again, if you're unwilling to change, do you really like the things that love is showing you? Because only those with their love in motion do. If you've stopped loving, that's what's coming to you is a lack of love. So do you want to know where your relationship is going to? It's going to the divorce court. If you won't stop and smell the roses, realize the priority has never been the job. It's never been advancement or the money. It's never been prestige. It's always been the one waiting for you day after day. And you know how long. Take them close, cherish them, hold them tighter than any monies in the world, for they are your riches, your richest riches. And so seek ye first the kingdom of love, and all things shall be added to you, says the Lord our God. So let your love be awake as a child, Let it go forth in motion and let it shine like never before. And so it's time to go forth so that all your deepest desires of love can be awakened. So let all people wanting the very best marriages ever, let their love to start overflowing like streams of waterfalls, brilliant, shining blue as a bluest sapphire for their sweeties. For like fine wine, they too shall grow much greater and finer with time, if their hearts are kept ablaze with love's forgiveness for one another. And know that unconditional love, once it's awakened, it has never been beyond any of us. It is capable for us all. And so know that if we love our husband or wife just because, then they can love us back no matter what they might do or what they might not do, to love for the sake of loving. For our Lord God loved us long before we loved him back. So try it sometime. You'll get far more honey with sugar, I promise you. So let all those wanting to shine as our fast rising sun of love that is now destroying all gross darkness, just as Isaiah 60 foretold for these latter days, let them all try their best at learning to love their other half without any conditions any longer, as they try daily to try helping them without any expectation. Lose the judgmentalism, lose the condemnation, just walk with them in love and forgive them of their errors as they forgive you of yours. And so it's time that we can all live together, and play together in the sandbox without throwing sand at one another. So if you want to live a life without regrets, it's time to discover your passion so that we can enjoy the little things like sailing away to beautiful skies. And so it's time, but we must realize that the only way any true love could ever possibly exist and last throughout a whole lifetime, the only way it can is the unconditionality of it. And that is the mystery of the Lamb of God, and the bridegroom cometh for his bride, the church. And so in this hour, the conditionality of the bridegroom is thrown away for all people faithful to wanting his love. And so it's time to welcome such a glorious kind of love, because it is that kind of love alone that is excitement in action, to come forth as a climax of our very best wishes manifesting all around us. So don't forget to ask your lover if they really know. Ask them if they really know if real love is just never a feeling. Instead, it's giving without remembering, and it's being able to receive without forgetting. And it's definitely not something to search for, but rather it's something that we all can hand out with overflowing happiness and overflowing joy eternal. So let all those wanting great marriages, let them become a giver of the gift of forgiveness to their partners in love. And I dedicate this video to my wife, Linda. We've been struggling for many years, so we welcome all your prayers, because we realize it's never gonna always be easy. It's hard work. But so let all people willing to follow, to carry your cross, to go forward in life, to give their unto their opponents, let them give them tolerance. And unto their friends, let them give a smile. And unto their children, good examples. And let every gift of Christ's most beautiful love in action, let it all be wrapped all over our hearts with his unconditional love. Because with his love as our way to move forward, he will make a way where it has seemed to be none, as he pulls down the mountains and lifts up the valleys, so that the age of the lion and the lamb can arise as the finest winds of his most blessed blessedness propels us ever forward by his overflowing magnificence of the beneficence of his benevolence, his overflowing charity and adoration, for all calling upon the name of the Lord shall truly be saved by love.